All right, so for number one, we're going to go ahead and add up the like terms of each of those. Okay. A lot of mistakes I see on these are not that you don't know how to do it, it's just that you kind of make a small mistake. I just checked 7 people's paper and 2 of you guys made real small mistakes, like didn't write down something. So be careful with that, because on a quiz or a test, you make that small mistake, you're going to get that X right next to it. So right here, we go and add our like terms together. I have 2x and -3x². I go ahead and put those together and I get -x². Then I have -3x and 1x. I go ahead and put those together. I get -2x. And I got 2 and 5. I go and add those up and I get 7. Okay. Number 2, with subtraction, you got to do a little more work. You shouldn't do it in one step like the addition. Make sure you put that this negative sign means you're multiplying by -1. So I have to go ahead and multiply each of these by -1 here. Okay. And I get -5x plus 3x³ minus 9. And I'm going to go ahead and then add them with these ones right here. So let's see, 4x³, I have a 4x³ and 3x³. I go and add those up, I get 7x³. Then I got -8x. And -5x, those two add up to -13x. And then I got +4 and -9, and those make a -5. Okay. All right, let's go ahead and find the product here. We're going to go ahead and multiply through. So one at a time here. So I'm going to go ahead and multiply -3x² times 5x². -3 times 5, I get -15x⁴. Again, adding exponents, 2 plus 2, we get the 4 there. Then I multiply the next. Also by -3x², I get -3 times 4 is -12x. And here's an x to the first power. So 1 plus 2, I get 3. Then here I got to multiply again. -3x² times -1, I get a +3x². Then next, I'm going to go ahead and multiply the next one, 2x, times each of those. So I do 2x times 5x². And I'm going to write that, line it up with what it's like terms here. 2 times 5 is going to be 10, and I'm going to get x³. So I'm going to line it up below the x³ here. 2x times 4x, I get 8x² and 2x times -1, I get -2x. Okay, then the last one, I just multiply the number through. 4 times 5x², I get 20x², so I line it up with the 20x² there. 4 times 4x, I get 16x. And the last one there, 4 times -1, I get -4. Okay. So I have them nicely lined up, so I can just add our like terms there. I bring down the -15x⁴. That doesn't change. This one would be negative 2x to the third. I go and add these up. I get 28x squared plus 3. It's going to be 31x squared. 16 minus 2, I get 14x. And lastly, a negative 4. All right, let's go ahead and look at our last thing we need to review, the dividing polynomial. So go ahead and write that one, and we'll go over it in just a second. Okay, all right, so let's go through this one here. X minus 5, I'm dividing that one. It doesn't have a square, and there's no term in front, so it's a pretty straightforward one where I can just use synthetic division. If, again, if it doesn't have a square, we use synthetic division. So I go ahead and change this one to a positive 5. And I write out the coefficients there. So 1's in front of the x to the 4th, 1. Then in front of the x to the 3rd is a negative 3. In front of the x, it goes 2 and negative 1. I'm not missing any terms, so I don't have any zeros in there. Then I go ahead and bring down that first term. And I get a 1. Then again, I go ahead, from now on, I just multiply, and then add. Multiply, then add. So multiply across, add down. So 5 times 1, I get 5. Add downwards, 5 minus 3, I get 2. Multiply across, 5 times 2, I get 10. Add downward, 2 plus 10, I get 12. I go ahead and multiply 5 times 12, I get 60. Then 60 minus 1, I get 59. And I need to go ahead and write in my coefficients there. It's x to the fourth, and I'm dividing by x to the first. So I subtract 1, bring that down by 1, I get x to the third. So I get x to the third plus 2x squared plus 12. Then my remainder at the end divided by x minus 5, the divisor. Yeah, question. X to the fourth. Because in the beginning here, we're dividing x to the fourth divided by x. So it'd be like x to the fourth divided by x to the first. And when you divide, you subtract. So it's like x to the fourth minus 1, and you get x to the third. Yeah. Did I miss something there? Let's see, x to the fourth. Oh, I see, I see, I see. You know what? Yeah, good point there. Actually, credit point for catching that mistake and raising in your hand. Okay, let's go through that again, actually. So you got this. We actually made a mistake. Let's see, anybody else want to get extra point, want to raise what I should have done with the blue numbers there? What about the blue numbers here? What do I need to add in there? Yeah.
Zero.
A zero, right? I need to add a zero between the negative three and the two. I'm missing a term in there. I'm missing x squared. Yeah, question? Because we need a placeholder. We need it to go down like x to the fourth, x to the third, then x squared, and then x, and then just a number. So I need to go ahead and let's go ahead and cross that out there. Okay. And the 5 doesn't change. The 1 doesn't change. I need to leave that in there. But I'm missing a 0 x squared in between here. So I'm going to add that in between the negative 3 and 2. So I get 1 minus 3, 0, 2, and negative 1. Okay. So I go ahead and bring down the first term as a 1. Multiply, get 5. Negative 3 and 5, I get 2. 5 times 2, I get 10. Add them up, I get 10 still because it's 0. 5 times 10, I get 50. 52. 5 times 52, it's a little bigger. I'm going to go ahead and multiply that on the side here. I get 260. Subtract 1, I get 259. And then I'm ready to go ahead and fill in x to the third plus x squared plus x plus just the number plus their divisor there, or the remainder. So important concept. Don't make that same mistake. If you're missing a term, you need to put a zero in there.